Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjaleyammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvenni. I am going to make a presentation on conducting, managing and assessment of online classes in this video lecture. So this is the news today. So பொறியியல் கல்லூரி மாணவர்களுக்கு இணைய வழியில் ஆகஸ்ட் 12 வகுப்புகள் தொடக்கம் அண்ணா பல்கலைக்கழகம் அறிவிப்பு. So we have to conduct the classes from 12th August for all the courses in engineering colleges. So how we are going to do it? So what is the modality that we have to follow for effectively conducting and monitoring, assessing an online class? That is what the presentation. I have 30 plus years of experience in teaching in engineering colleges. With that experience, right now I am using online mode also for making my presentation to the students. So based on my experience, I want to share my knowledge with the colleagues. So daily conducting 6 hours online, is it possible? So nowadays we are conducting many webinars across various engineering colleges on various advanced topics for the benefit of the faculty member as well as the students. Maybe for 1 hour, 2 hour we conduct a webinar, but conducting 6 hours classes daily, the subject content, delivering subject content through online 6 hours or 4 hours per day, is it possible? So what are the problems? Few problems what the student and the faculty member may face or facing today for their online teaching. It may be network problem. So there are 2G, 4G, 5G mobiles. So maybe majority of the students, they use only 2G network connectivity. So in the remote places where our student, majority of our students are from rural places, so there is a possibility of network problem. And that was made as a complaint in recent days by the students when we offered the course for the second semester courses, second semester subjects. So they had some problem with the network. And disturbance from the family members. So when we are attending classes, obviously there is no separate room for many of the students here in our place, particularly rural places. So definitely there will be disturbance from the family members. No data connection, so continuously 6 hours, so they require some cost, whether to connect, get the connection from any of the network provider. So the cost involved. So majority of the students, they may report that there is no data connection for observing or listening to the class continuously for 6 hours. Sometimes students, they may switch on the class and doing some other work. They may not actively participate or listen to the class. So that is not possible. That is also possible. And the teacher is effectively presenting, make many information on air, float many information on air through online mode using the computer or laptop, mobile. But how much content went to the mind of the student through online mode? That is also a big question. And it is boring. So continuously watching the screen continuously, it is very difficult. It is boring for anybody, or even for the teachers. Now, what is the solution? So LMS. So the effective way to conduct, monitor, assess, or evaluate classes online is learning management system. So worldwide, they are using it. Some of the engineering colleges in Tamil Nadu also, they are using the LMS for as a supporting tool for their teaching. In addition to the regular classroom teaching, they are using LMS for giving additional courses or the main course through LMS. So these are all the benefits. These are all the benefits. So the content delivery is easy. We can go for course collaboration. So we can easily track the progress. We can give assignment through online. We can have practice classes and examination. So it is easy for the student and the instructor. They can easily master the course. How we are going to work with the LMS? So content delivery is also very easy. Instead of continuously talking inside the classroom for 40 minutes and making the student to listen to the class and take notes. So what we can do, we can make the content in the form of a script or in the form of video and share with the students through LMS. So they will listen to the video or listen to the PDF content on the lesser time repeatedly for many times so that they can easily understand and they will master in the subjects. So these are all the benefits on the LMS. And the benefits using LMS on different organizations. Many of the corporates also using LMS for their training or training their employees. So it is a world-class training. So self-paced learning. So they can learn on their own pace. So they need not necessarily, compulsorily be online for the specific time by the teacher. Instead of it, they can open the net at any time on their leisure time and open it and learn on their own pace. Continuous learning is possible. So not only this course, they can learn continuously online. So performance driven. So there may be, we can conduct some performances online based on the performance test. Others score, the score of other people, other fellow peer student, they can monitor so that it will be drive their performance. So as a teacher, you can update the content continuously. You can update the content and it will be effective learning for both the teacher and the student. It will be effective learning. So it will be effective learning. It is a world-class training methodology online. So self, this is the benefit for the student. They can learn on their own pace and the continuous learning is possible for the student. So the for teacher, it is update. They can easily update the content through the LMS. And these are all the LMS available. Instructor, Canvas, Bridge, Blackboard, Google Classroom, Drupal, Moodle. So I am familiar with the Canvas. I am working with the Canvas. I am conducting courses with the Canvas. So I give the brief introduction to the Canvas platform so that the interested people, interested faculty members, whoever is listening to the video, you can try the Canvas Instructor for managing your classes during this pandemic situation. So I will explain you now how to manage the classes, conduct and manage the classes with the, using the Canvas Instructor. I explain you online. So open the Google tab. You search for Canvas Instructor. So this screen will appear. You select the Canvas by Instructor. So already I have an account. So that account number, email, preferably use your email for your account so that the update you can easily do, you can share the update through the email, and whenever the student are responding, the message will appear on your email, so it is easy to monitor. So preferably you have email as your username. And suppose if you are first time you are doing, so you click here, need a Canvas account, you can observe the formalities and create an account here. I log in. So already I have few courses on the on the Canvas platform dashboard, and now I am going to explain how to create a new course on the Canvas platform. So you start a new course. You have to type the course name. I type the course name as Internal Combustion Engine. You can have the short name for the internal combustion engine. I have a short name ICE. So you create a course. You click the create a course. So the course is created. The title is ICE engine. And you can have number of modules. Maybe you can divide the entire, for example, first unit, first module, second unit, second module, like that. You can have number of modules. I can even name the module name. I take the, introduce the module. I take module 1. I take introduction is the topic. I click add module. So the module is added. Now I want to add instructions to the course material, video, anything on this module. You please click the plus sign, so you can select anything. So you can add a page, you can add some external URL of videos, and you can attach the assignment, you can attach a quiz here. I include the lecture notes, assignment. Now you have to click this assignment. So you have to I take file, new file, choose the file. I take from the, actually I have in my computer. So this is my, I have one course, thermal engineering 1, internal combustion engine. I have the lecture number 16. Open it and add the item. So now this is added. Now what is the advantage? The student, they can learn. All right, I add one more thing. I add one more thing using the external URL, or I can external tool, or even I can take the file, choose the file. The YouTube video, so this is difficult. Uploading entire file is difficult. I go to my YouTube account and attach the link. External URL, I go to my channel, YouTube channel. I have the playlist, IC engine. I have the first video. Copy the link address and paste the link here. Add item. Name, introduction. Introduction, add item. Now it is added here, link is added. So this you can also publish. So what the student can do, they can click the link so that they will download the file. So this file will open here. They can read the file. They can read the file here, or they can download the file to their desktop, and they can learn, listen to the lecture notes and their leisure time, or they can listen to the video. That will take them to the YouTube video. They can listen to the video here. Or they can download the video and then they can listen to the video on their convenient time. So that is also possible. So uploading the information file, or you can even upload a quiz here. I can add a quiz. So your new quiz, then you can give the quiz name. Once again, I give introduction. Unnamed quiz, you will make it as unnamed quiz. You click the quiz, you have to design the quiz completely, and then you have to publish the quiz. So the quiz is published. So you go to the home page again for the subject, and the quiz is available now for the student. The students can click and answer the quiz, and once they complete the quiz, so it will be online. It is updated, I mean evaluated. So like that you can add module, number of module you can add. So finally you have to publish the quiz, publish the subject. So they publish this module. So this entire module is published, you have to publish so that the students can access to it, and then you have to publish the subject course. So the course is published. So you'll get the green color published. Now how to share the content with the student? Now you go to the setting. So the course image you can add here. So the course name is internal combustion engine, course code is ICE, or you can have anything. And it is created on 8th August 1159. And you can have some end time. So when you put the end time here, so after that it may not be available to the student, and the student can only participate in the course between these dates. So you click it, restrict the student from viewing this course after the end date. That also you can select, restrict the students viewing the course before the start date. That also, whatever is applicable, so you can select whatever it is. Then other conditions you just read, and now you everything you can describe the course, everything you can add. So set, it is online on campus, you can make it as online. So update the course details. And the course successfully updated, and we have to share the information with the students. More option. Now listen, and you can share, enroll, let the student self enroll by sharing with them the URL code. So you can click it and join the course, and add a join this course link to the home page. That also you can click, then update the course information. Once again the instruction, it appears. So this course has been enabled open enrollment. Student can self enroll in the course once they share the item URL. So you have to share this URL to the student. So you copy it and you share to the students by mail ID, or through WhatsApp you can share. So I share with the mail ID. So I go to my mail, now I compose a mail. So you can copy it and to share through WhatsApp, that is easy. So by clicking the the content, the student can register to the course. So the mail ID is, I have another mail ID, paste the content, I have another mail ID, I share with this mail ID, I send this information to my mail ID, another mail ID. Now I log out from here, so from this course I log out. So my account, I am logging out. Now I open my mail ID. So there is one new instruction. Look at here, this course has been enabled to open enrollment. Students can self-enroll URL HTTP canvas instructor. You can click that, or they can log in, register, and then using this code. So I click it, so straight away it will take me to the, so this page, and I write my mail ID. I am a new user, full name Kannan. I agree to accept to the points, enroll this course. Oh, already in use, so I use another mail ID. Enroll this course. So this page will appear for the candidate Selvarani. Go to the course and this is appearing. ICE module is appearing. Now for the student, if they select the dashboard, there is only one course available for the candidate. For the student it will be available, so they can click it, they can use the, as I told already, you can use it introduction, they can be listen to the video, they can listen to the download and use the lecture content, and they can appear for the quiz examination. So this LMS, so you can create the course, provided you can have the, I mean, many of the teachers nowadays, they have the well-prepared notes, a soft copy of the notes, maybe in the form of Word or PDF is available. So better share with the PDF format, and you can prepare the video wherever possible, or you can even take video, download the video, the existing video available online. That link also you can share with the students, so that the ultimate idea is making this student informed about the subject and make them to learn. So this is the using Canvas for instructing, and the assignment you can give. For example, you can add for the same course. You can home page. I go to the home page. I can give assignments. You can, the student, they can click the assignment. So there is a quiz available, so they can participate in the quiz. And for the teacher, you can upload all assignment, quiz program, even the problem you can give in the form of quiz. So you can design a problem in such that the answer will be appearing as a quiz answer with the multiple choices. So if they select the correct answer, it will give the mark and it will give the explanation. If they select the wrong answer, again it will give the explanation about the correct answer. So like that you can design the quiz program online, or you can use some Quizmaster software available online. So using that software you can design the quiz. At that link you can share here. So it is very easy for the student. So they need not work online for 6 hours for listening to the subject. They can open the net for 1 hour, go to the LMS, and they can download all the information whatever available online, and they can leisurely on their free time they can listen and they can learn. So that is the advantage for the student. Now this is about the Canvas instructor. Now I give how to record the video. Many of you know familiar with some of the video recording technique. So I am using one tool called Screencast-O-Matic. How to use the Screencast-O-Matic for recording the video, that also I will explain. So once again I go to the net, I close all these tabs, I go to the Google. Yes, I go to the Google. You can type Screencast-O-Matic. This will appear. You select it, and if you look at the home page of the Screencast-O-Matic, start free recording. So you can even record the video for free, but the condition is maximum of 15 minutes. Or you can purchase it. So you can purchase the product for any one of, there are many scheme available. So you can purchase it for pricing, you can find out according to your convenience. So 1900 rupees minimum per year. You can record any number of hours of video, any numbers of video we can record for any number of hours. So if you try the free recording, it will be maximum of 15 minutes. So according to your convenience, you can select. I have my own account here. So I select my videos. Then you go for recording. So the recording already is going. So that is why it is not up. The screen is appearing. So recording screen will appear. You have to record. So I am right now recording the entire presentation through Screencast-O-Matic. You can record the content. You can use the PPT. You can use the PPT for recording the all the content. So Screencast-O-Matic is one tool. There are other many tools are available. So but this is a convenient tool for recording the video lectures. And what are the effective ways? Now you follow this, if possible you follow this for making your subject content, delivery of the subject content effectively. Use any of the LMS. So Moodle, Canvas, Google Classroom, according to your convenience, use any of the LMS. So Google everything is free for teachers. So prepare your content, lecture notes, video, assignment, quiz, etc. and upload in the LMS and monitor the progress. How many students visited the lecture notes, how many students visited the video, how many students visited, how many students answered the quiz program, how many students answered your assignment, everything you can monitor periodically. Weekly 1 hour you can meet the student online using any of the meeting app and address their problem and doubt. So instead of everyday meeting 1 hour, it is not possible because there are 6 subjects, all the 6 teachers. 1 hour per day, 6 hours, it is not possible. At least once in a day, any one of the teacher, they can call for an online meeting with the students to clarify their doubt on the subject notes, what is uploaded for the 1 week reading. So they can, at the end of the 1 week reading, they can conduct the quiz program, they can give the assignment. So once the students submit the quiz or assignment, you can evaluate the progress of the student. When they log in to the LMS, attendance will be marked. So you need not worry about the physical attendance. Whenever they log in to the LMS for a particular course, the attendance will be entered. So whenever they enter to the quiz program, again it will be recorded. So everything will be recorded. When they log into the LMS attendance, attendance will be marked. When they submit the assignment, date will be noted. When they answer to the quiz, online evaluation is done. So presenting, managing and assessing a course using LMS is the best way. Instead of conducting online courses for 6 hours in a day, which is difficult for both the teachers and the students. So thank you for listening to me. So if you have any queries, you can write to my mail ID or you can call me through my number. I will share if you have any doubt on the managing with the Canvas and the Screencast-O-Matic.